In the late 80s, graphic designers were skeptical of ditching their pencils for pixels. They wondered if the essence of design could survive the digital wave. Now we're standing on the cusp of another transformation, and it's even more of a game changer. Want to hear the story? Hey there, I'm Tiffany, and you're watching Cocoy AI. Today we're deep diving on a topic that's absolutely vital for every designer and creative thinker, the future of design with AI. Let me take you back in time to give you a real life example. As a child, I watched my parents work as graphic designers. Their tools, sheets of special lettering, big film cameras, sharp blades for cutting board and paper, hot wax to put it all together. They used these tools to make layouts that were sent off to be printed. And they absolutely drew things by hand. But then computers arrived on the scene. What a game changer. The way my parents' work started to shift. Some of their friends who worked in the same field didn't think they need to adapt. They were experts in separating colors for printing, a skill that used to be essential. But soon it became clear those who didn't learn new computer skills got left behind. The smart ones, my parents included, decided to learn these new tools. They understood the future was knocking at their door. They also started me early on the SE30, learning about Bezier curves and Photoshop with only one undo. Can you imagine? Only one undo. Fast forward to the era of web. Remember the early days of internet design? It was Wild West out there. I was right there in the mix, using Flash and ActionScript to create web designs that were, for that time, cutting edge. But as you can guess, change was in the air again. The iPhone made Flash obsolete, bringing in with new importance with languages like JavaScript, CSS, and HTML5. This evolution didn't stop. Companies merged, software changed hands, macromedia became Adobe, Photoshop and Fireworks had their spotlight moments, but then came Sketch, Principle, and now Figma. Throughout all these changes, what remained constant was the need to adapt, to keep learning. I did it, my parents did it, and this new wave of AI, it's just the next chapter in this ever-changing story. So if you're thinking, do I have to learn another new thing? The answer is a resounding yes. Adaptability isn't just a skill, it's a survival tactic in our field. All right, so we've looked back at the past, but what's next? What's the future landscape for creative thinkers like us? First, let's talk strategy and human needs. With AI taking on more of the routine tasks, we're freed up to focus on groundbreaking innovation. Creativity in its truest form is becoming the new currency. While AI is incredibly powerful, it learns from what's come before. It can't easily go from zero to one, from nothing to a completely new invention. That's where we come in. Humans have the unique ability to create the next big thing. With AI in the mix, we will solve human needs in more democratized ways than ever before. Second, fear not. AI isn't replacing us, it's empowering us. All functions, not just design, are affected by AI. So if you've ever wanted to explore finance or marketing, now you can. AI has democratized knowledge. However, process still matters. The best solutions come from a thoughtful decision-making, not just quick AI-generated answers. You have to work with the machine in order to get good results. It often takes even more back and forth with the computer-generated response to get something that's even remotely useful. You have to be the human and tell it what is good. The computer is just there to respond to your prompts. Now let's unpack the magic of the Venn diagram where desirability, feasibility, and viability intersect. This is the sweet spot. But getting there is a journey. An idea can spark from any of these circles. With AI, the initial human-AI collaboration can set the iterative process in motion, gradually getting us closer to the center of the diagram. It's our job to steer it there. Take Tesla, for example. It started primarily in the feasibility circle with electric vehicle technology, but through constant iteration and public feedback, it's moving closer and closer to becoming more desirable and economically viable. I recently started in the Stanford Leads program, and I was happy to see that Airbnb was the first case study that we were solving for. I think that Airbnb starting their focus on desirability resonates with my ideal upbringing of starting with desirability first, solving for a real need. As the platform evolved, it addressed viability and feasibility issues, inching closer to that sweet spot. And now Airbnb is used as a case study at Stanford Business School. It's amazing. And let's not forget about smartphones. For example, the iPhone, they came with a heavy focus on viability. But as technology improved, they become more feasible and more desirable, touching the lives of billions. Can you imagine your life without one? The key is to collaborate with the AI. In the same way that we collaborate with people, it's an iterative process. The closer we get to the middle of the Venn diagram, the more balanced and successful our designs will be. And remember, iteration is a never-ending journey. Just because it's good enough for now, it offers the promise that it will be iterated on and get better over time. This is not the end. This is only the beginning. All right, let's get down to the nitty-gritty. How can you start incorporating AI into your creative process today? First off, there are some amazing tools out there. Consider checking out Midjourney, Pika Labs, or even ChatGPT for aspects of the creative process. One tip is to ask ChatGPT how it can be incorporated into the design process or any creative process, and it'll give you an answer on the best ways to working with that tool. It's like asking a person, what are the ways that you like to work? How would you like to work with me? And you can tell it back the same. Custom rules that you can add to ChatGPT that allow you to give your thoughts to ChatGPT so that it gets to know how you like to work. And Midjourney, try to create something in Midjourney that you would normally create in other ways and experiment with prompting. Try to recreate something that you've seen in the world or something similar. What would you use to describe those things in order for the computer to understand what you are getting at? The other thing to consider is the same as what I just said about ChatGPT. Give it an image reference and see how Midjourney would describe it. I will say those prompts don't always turn out the way that you expect it to, but you can get an idea of how a computer would assess the image that you've uploaded. And Pika Labs is just a really fun way to get your foot wet into animating with AI. You know, you can upload an image from anywhere or describe what you would like to see in that animation, and it spits out a cute little animation. It's free, so that's a plus. I will say ChatGPT for the paid version is way more extensible than the free version, but try it out. I used ChatGPT, the free version, for a long time before I really committed to exploring what that did. If you're the kind of person who loves diving deep, there are plenty of articles and videos that can guide you. I'll link to some of the best resources in the description below. I watched a video on the future of design thinking. It's right here. That you can check out that kind of goes through what this person's thoughts are on the future of design. And finally, how do you actually integrate AI into your workflow? Well, start weaving it into each step of your creative process. Experiment with what's possible today, because I promise you it's gonna get even better tomorrow, and maybe literally tomorrow. These AI tools, from the point where I first started playing with it to now, they have exponentially gotten better and better with every iteration. Don't wait for perfection. AI is evolving rapidly, and the sooner you get on board, the better equipped you'll be for the future. So start small, iterate, and learn as you go. So there you have it. Practical ways to make your AI your creative ally. The future is promising, and the tools are at your fingertips. Wow, we've covered a lot of ground today, haven't we? From the transformative history of design to the game-changing impact of AI. One thing's clear, the future for creative thinkers like us is incredibly bright. We stand at the intersection of technology and human creativity, empowered to solve complex problems and meet human needs like never before. And the best part? This journey is far from over. We're just getting started. With tools like Midjourney, Pika Labs, and ChatGPT, not to mention an array of resources to deepen our knowledge, the sky's the limit. So here's my challenge to you. Take one action today. Whether it's reading an article or trying new software, or simply brainstorming how AI can fit into your workflow, take that step. Your future self will thank you. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you found value in this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, let's keep pushing the boundaries of what is possible. Peace.